This is your Blue Line BJJ Tip of the Week. Today we're going to be talking about handcuffing and two kind of important concepts that go with handcuffing that are oftentimes overlooked. When I have a subject here, he's turned away from me. I've told him he's under arrest, but I haven't gone to make contact yet. As I'm approaching, one of the things I like to see officers do is approach with the hands up. You should not have your handcuffs in your hands yet. You got to keep your hands free in case the fight is on. And as I approach with my hands up, I'm going to give him a slight touch. And the reason for this is, as I'm about to make contact, he in his head may be trying to develop a game plan. Is he going to run on the touch? Is he going to turn to fight me on the touch? And he's waiting for some kind of cue from me. So as I come in, if I were just to kind of grab onto his hands right now, I may have just set off that jack-in-the-box of him running or him turning to fight me. I'd rather do it while I'm here and my hands are up so I can react accordingly. If he doesn't move, if he remains cooperative with this light touch, I like to take my foot and place it to the heel of my strong side. So if my right hand is in front as I'm walking up, my right foot, outside of my right foot, goes to touch his heel. And the reason I do this is because if he is going to turn to fight me as I make this kind of contact, I'm forcing him to take a long pivot step around to me. If I don't have this inside heel control, he takes a short step in, and now right away, we're in close contact. So what I'm doing is I'm buying myself a little more time by making him go the long way around, and then in turn, I can start to crush him, get into a clinch, get into the fight, wherever it's going to be. I can see that attack better than if it's an inside pivot this way, and he's right in my space. That is your Blue Line BJJ Tip of the Week.